Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Diachronic Ghost on this Destiny 2 video, and today we'll be taking a look at a build that I made that's centered around the Elemental Wells. If you did not know, the Elemental Well is one of the new seasonal mods with Season of the Chosen, kind of like Charger Light or Warmind South, as a completely different thing. And honestly, if you are not using Elemental Wells in any of your builds, you are missing out. Not only are there a bunch of different things you can do with the Elemental Well bonuses, there is a bridge between Elemental Wells and Charger Light, but just generally, whenever you pick up an elemental well, you get ability regeneration across the board. And if you've ever played in PvP, you know abilities and stasis is really strong. And in PvE, having more abilities always helps. So just off the bat, elemental wells are something that's really interesting and really effective. Today, we're going to be taking a look at a PvE Void Warlock build that is designed around using the elemental wells and Controverse Hold to get powerful and fast charging Void Grenades while also getting a tier 10 intellect very easily. Again, this may seem simple, but it works extremely well in PvE game modes and actually scales pretty well into the high level Nightfalls. And with this build, you will often see that your grenade instantly recharges nearly every time you throw it. On top of being fun, this is also a build that I would see viable for Grandmaster Nightfalls. And potentially even more viable next season if we get Oppressive Darkness and Overload grenades back for Void grenades, as that made it so much more powerful. But even then, combining the Charger Light stuff and the new Elemental Well stuff has made this an incredibly fun build to use. And just a little background info, if you're not familiar with the Elemental Wells, there are 6 new Elemental Well mods you can get from the helm. 3 of them that are designed around getting the wells generated from either grenade kill, scaling weapon kills, and super kills, and the other 3 on using them. First one being able to bridge the gap between Charge of Light and Elemental Wells. The second one giving you an intellect bonus, plus 50 for 30 seconds, and the last one giving you a damage bonus. And of course, throughout this video, you'll be seeing pictures of a document that I created for you guys to use, fully public, over at my Discord server, link in the description down below, in the channel hashtag spreadsheets docs, and it includes everything I'll be talking about today, including the specs and everything you'll see on screen. Right, so moving forward, let's go ahead and get into the specifics of this build. First up, we have the class and subclass, which I've picked the Warlock Void Attunement of Chaos, which is going to be that big slow of a bomb with lots of damage, and the accelerated chaos charging grenades. And this is going to be very important because it pairs up really nicely with Controverse Hold, as opposed to Devour, which just consumes grenades. For the rest of the subclass, I like using Vortex Grenade, Healing Rift, and Burst Glide. Personal preference on Vortex Grenade, you can easily use one of the other ones. I just find that it has better DPS, better AoE, and of course the dot over time. Next up, for the weapons, you could really use anything. It's not really built on the weapons, but I would personally recommend picking a weapon that has Demolitionist. My personal preference is going to be something like True Prophecy, First and Last Out, and Anarchy. Obviously, if you're playing in higher level play, you're going to want to switch out that shotgun for Ariana's Vow, and then go with something like Interference 6. Pretty much all the weapons that are recommended in this document has the potential of having Demolitionist. However, if you wanted to know more of them, on my document, I actually have a link to all of the weapons that have Demolitionist. If you don't know, on LightGG, you can literally look up a perk, i.e. Demolitionist, and it shows every weapon that can get it. Up next, let's talk about your armor, oftentimes the most sophisticated and important part of any build. First and foremost, you do not have to set up your build exactly like I have it. This is just one way I found to optimize it. I'll be talking about the important parts right now. Secondly, most of the armor here is gonna be solar. So if you don't have a lot of solar armor, either you're gonna have to convert or get some solar armor, because a lot of these, you have to have it solar. For the exotic choice, I have chosen Controverse Hold, which works incredibly well with grenades, specifically charged void grenades, and scales very well into Grandmaster Nightfalls because it only requires you to get grenade hits. Whereas a lot of exotics lose out because they require you to get a kill. And the last and often most important part, we have these seasonal mods. First up, Elemental Ordnance, where your grenade kills spawn an Elemental Well. This is sometimes a little bit spotty, but usually happens, which is going to be your number one and only source of Elemental Wells. You also have another perk called Font of Wisdom, where every time you pick up an Elemental Well, you have 30 seconds of plus 50 intellect. This is actually just going to be piggybacking on the fact you're going to be spawning Elemental Wells all the time, which, you know, plus 50 intellect is always nice to have. The next one is Elemental Charge, allowing you to get Charge of Light from picking up an Elemental Well, which bridges the gap between Charge of Light and the Elemental Wells. And if that well is matching color to your subclass, you get 2 stacks of Charge with Light, which if you're getting Void Grenade kills, you also have a Void subclass. The only time it won't be Void is if your teammates are using a non-Void subclass, which is fine. Getting 1 stack of Charge with Light from your teammates' wells is just a bonus. Beyond that, we also have two other mods that are exactly the same. We have two stacks of firepower, which actually does stack, giving you an extra 15% of your grenade back for one stack of charge with light every time you use a grenade. And it does stack, allowing you to get 30% of your grenade just off the bat for one stack of charge with light. Which in turn means you have two chances of two grenades to get a single elemental well to get back your charge with light. Which, if you can't get a single grenade kill with two chaos accelerated vortex grenades, then you're probably just throwing it at a boss. Beyond that, everything else should be pretty straightforward. Discipline, recovery, bomber, ashes to assets, makes sense. When it comes to your stats, getting recovery to 7+ across the board in PvE is very useful. Many people think recovery is PvP only, but it is important in PvE. Also, getting a high discipline of 7+, even though you are trying to get that instant grenade, getting it faster in the tiny space that you have is still useful. For mobility, I like having 4-6. Personal preference, perhaps escaping shots and being very aggressive is more my playstyle, may not be yours. And finally, a low to medium intellect at 5 maximum, and that way Font of Wisdom has the maximum effect. And the rest don't really impact the build much. Next up, let's talk about the gameplay, because how you use this build is going to often be just as important as how you build it. The general flowchart is you're going to want to charge up your grenade, throw it at an enemy. As long as you are hitting the enemy, you get the controversy bonus, and if you have charge with light, you get the bonus as well. If you end up killing that enemy, you can pick up an elemental well, get the ability to regeneration, and then of course get your stacks of charge with light and start the process over again. If you don't end up getting the kill, you have a second charge with light charge to then get a kill with that grenade. And at that point, if you don't get a kill, then you're just going to have to get carried by controversy hold, which is always going to be there and always going to give you more grenade back. The important part is you're always charging a grenade, which you should keep in mind that if you're charging a grenade with controversy hold, you also get a little bit of resistance, so it's not the worst thing in the world. Beyond that, your charged melee can actually generate grenade energy on hit, but should be avoided on the high level play as it's quite dangerous. Your super should be used on bosses, mini bosses, elites, and group of enemies, really whenever possible, because you have so much faster charge with Font of Wisdom. Super generating bonuses like ashes to assets, just use your Nova Bomb at will. Do not be too good to use syndrome. When it comes to your weapons, you should use them as the combination insists. So if you're using my personal recommendations, you have True Prophecy, First and Last Doubt, and Anarchy, you're going to want to save your Anarchies for those elites and for those boss enemies, obviously having very high total amount of damage, meaning you can use it pretty often. Using your shotgun on those elite enemies, anything that doesn't die to a few primary shots, and then True Prophecy on literally everything else, as in my opinion, the number one best PvE weapon in the game. Well, for primaries, that is. Keeping in mind that whatever weapon you have Demolitionist on, you should use when you need your grenade back. And even if you don't have a weapon with Demolitionist, you're probably going to be getting your grenades 4-5 times as often as you would normally anyways, and that's just stonks. I gotta stop saying stonks, but it's just stonks. And lastly, let's talk about the alternatives, of which there are so many alternatives. Firstly, you can use any of the weapon options that I mentioned above, or any weapon that you really want. Just make sure you make the appropriate mod changes to your armor. Secondly, your subclass can also be changed to any grenade-based build, like Attunement of Hunger with Nezarek Sin, Attunement of Sky with Sunbracers, Attunement of Conduction with Crown of Tempest, or honestly, any grenade-based build on any class. This is just one particular build that I came up with that I thought would be really good with the Elemental Wells. For the rest of your subclass, you could also change your Rift and your Jump and even your Grenade to whatever option you like. I just prefer those options. As long as you're getting hits with your grenade, that's all that matters. And finally, you can also change around a number of things with your armor mods and still make it a very viable build. Firstly, you can switch firepower with Font of Wisdom on your legs and chest if you prefer having your chest as the solar item and your legs as the innie. Removing Font of Wisdom altogether for a third firepower, bringing up your firepower bonus from 30% to 45%. If you really don't care about your super, for example, if you're using Attunement Conduction with Crown Tempest, Stormcaller is really not that beneficial. Or, for example, swapping out one bomber for special ammo finisher on your class item, as you know, 2 points for 2 points is really easy. And of course, etc., etc., just replace the mods that you see fit. And that is going to be pretty much the end of the video. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any questions or concerns. Also, please let me know what kind of builds you guys have been making with Elemental Wells, as I'm just getting started and experienced with these things. I want to see what kind of things that can be done. Currently, we only have one connection between Charged Light and Elemental Wells. I would like to see Bungie adding more as we go forward, and even more connections to other parts. For example, using elemental wells with Warmind cells, or using elemental wells with other teammates. I would really like to see an extremely optimized team of three guardians with crazy setups with elemental wells, charged with light, Warmind cells that could all build off each other, like powerful friends, like radiant light, and all the little pieces in between. I would like to see more of this and more connections. Because the more connections we have, the more insane our builds can become. And of course, as always, I want to give a big shout out to my patrons on Patreon. A lot of these videos wouldn't be possible without their help, perhaps would even have to stop doing entire series. Specifically, I want to give a big thank you to Matty Buju, Mom, Dad, Charles, William, Joe Smith, Monday, Natalie Hoppins, Steve Bachnowitz, Justin Rare, Raymond Showman, Yuta Panther, Cole Sherman, Casey Reagan for their support on Patreon. And if you want to make this list harder, again, link in the description down below to my Patreon. Check it out. But yeah, that's the end of it. My name is Winnie Chronic, and I'll see you guys on the next one.